In our last video, we learned how a metric could induce a topology. And we defined a topology in the real line, the bar of x and y. So we have x, y, two elements in the real line. We defined the bounded distance between x and y to be the minimum between x minus y, the absolute value, so the usual distance, and 1. And we saw that this, the bar, induce the same topology as the usual distance in the real line. So now the idea will be to define a new topology in R omega. Remember, R omega was just the product of a countable many times the real numbers. We'll define a metric in R omega and then just have the topology induced by that metric. That metric is called the uniform metric, and it's a metric in R omega, so given x and y, two elements in R omega, we define this uniform metric rho bar of x and y. To define it, let's say that x is going to be xn for n natural number, and the same with y. It's going to be a tuple of elements in the real line, so each yn is a real number. And then we define this metric rho bar to be the supremum over all the natural numbers of the bounded distance between the coordinates xn and yn. So we calculate all the bounded distances between each component of x and y, because remember, t bar is a metric in the real line and each xn, yn are real numbers. We calculate all of these distances and then take the supremum of them. This is the rho bar distance between the elements in the product space R omega, x and y. And so, as I said before, we know that because this is a metric, it induces a topology called the uniform topology. We're going to call it tau unif from uniform. And so now we have in our omega, we have three topologies. We have the product topology, the box topology, and now we added a new one, the uniform. And now these three topologies are the same if we are talking about a finite product. So basically, they are all the same in Rn. But what happens when we are in a countable product? Well, in a countable product, we knew something about tau product and tau box. We knew that the product topology was a subset of the box topology. So where is the uniform? Well, what happens is that it's in the middle. So the product topology is a subset of the uniform and a subset of the box topology. Let's prove these two inclusions. We will start proving that the product topology is a subset of the uniform topology. To prove this, we're going to use the lemma that we saw on the basis video. So we are going to take an element in the basis of the product topology and prove that there exists an element in the uniform topology that is a subset of that element we took in the product. Remember what the product topology was like. If we take x in R omega and u, a neighborhood of x in the product topology, then we know that u is going to be the product of sets un, where un is equal to the real numbers except for finitely many indexes n. So what we can do is take these finite elements n and give them some names. Let's call them n1, n2, and so on up to nm. Be such that uni is different from the real line for every I between 1 and m. So I'm just grabbing all the sets in the product that are different from the real numbers. Now each of these sets is open, And so for each of these, there exists epsilon I, a positive number such that I can graph a ball in the bounded metric. It could be in the usual metric, but I can just make the radius smaller and take it with the bounded metric. We center in the corresponding x and I, and this radius such that it's a subset of u and I. This is simply using that these sets are open in the real numbers. And so I can do this for each one of these subindexes and sub I. But these are only a finite amount of indexes. So I can just take epsilon to be the minimum of all these numbers epsilon I for I between 1 and m. I have a finite list of positive numbers, I'm just taking the minimum. Now the ball with the uniform metric, we center at this element x that we took, and the epsilon I've just defined is a subset of u, where u, remember, was the neighborhood we took of x, was just the product of these elements u n. Why is this? Well, what happens if I take y, an element in this ball? So by definition, rho var of the distance between x and y in the uniform metric is smaller than epsilon. But remember how this metric was defined. It was the supremum over all the distances in the bounded metric between the components. So then if the supremum is smaller here than epsilon, then what happens is that all of them are less than epsilon. So the bar of xn yn is smaller than epsilon for every n. And so what happens here is all these un's are the real numbers except for this finite amount. So obviously the coordinates of y are real numbers, all of them. So I only care about those coordinates for which the un is not the real numbers, because that one is the restriction. But now if all these distances are smaller than epsilon, then in particular x and I and the corresponding coordinate of y is smaller than epsilon, where this index n I is one for which these sets are not the real numbers. And so because this is smaller than epsilon, and epsilon was defined as the minimum of all of this, then in particular it will be smaller than the corresponding EI. And so this means that y and I is an element in the ball with the bounded metric centered in x and I and radius EI. But remember that each of these balls was a subset of u and I. And so this means that y and I is an element in u and I. And obviously all the other indexes are real numbers, so we have this. We were able to find an element in the basis for the uniform topology that is contained in the neighborhood of one element in the product topology. So that proves this inclusion. Now let's prove that the uniform topology is a subset of the box topology. For this, again, we're going to take an element in R omega, and we have to take a neighborhood of X in the uniform topology. So just consider the ball with the uniform metric centered at X and with some radius epsilon for some epsilon positive. I should now find an open set in the box topology that is a subset of this neighborhood. Well, for this, just consider U to be the product over all the natural numbers of each index minus epsilon over 2 and the same index plus epsilon over 2. So this is just the usual interval in the real line, and we are taking the product for each coordinate of x. So let's see that u is a subset of this ball. For this, let's take an element y in u and prove that y is an element in this ball. To prove this, we would have to take this distance and see that it's smaller than epsilon. Now, this distance, by definition, is the supremum of all the bounded distances between the coordinates. And so, given that y is an element in u, that means that each component of y is an element in this set. And so this is going to be smaller than epsilon over 2, because each of these is smaller than so is the supremum. And then trivially, y is an element in this ball, which proves this inclusion. And with this, we finish the video, but we will continue working with metric topologies in the next one.